If you're keeping up with the literature on health span, then you must have heard the phrase stem cell exhaustion. What is it? Stem cell exhaustion refers to the gradual decline in the ability of stem cells to self-renew and differentiate as we age. So cells not only renew, they differentiate into different metabolic pathways, but more important, into different activities, functional activities. This means that they lose their capacity to both replicate themselves to maintain and to maintain a steady population. Also, they lose their ability to transform themselves into specialized cells needed for tissue repair and regeneration. This decline in stem cell function is directly related to the aging process. As we get older, our stem cells accumulate various forms of quote unquote cellular damage, including what is called DNA damage. This can occur due to factors like exposure to free radicals and toxins. It's also connected to telomere shortening. Telomeres are the protective caps on the ends of chromosomes that shorten with each cell division. When they become too short, cells can no longer divide effectively. Also, stem cell exhaustion is related to epigenetic changes, which are alterations in gene expression that can affect stem cell function. All these factors contribute to a decrease in the number and the quality of stem cells in our bodies. This, in turn, leads to a reduced capacity for tissue repair and regeneration, which is a hallmark of aging. This reduced regeneration manifests in various ways as we age, such as very obviously, and something that can be measured, decreased wound healing, also weaker immune function, also increased susceptibility to age-related diseases such as cardiovascular disorders, neurodegenerative disorders, cancer, metabolic disorders, etc. Well, is there a way to completely prevent stem cell exhaustion? Not right now, but there are many things you can do to minimize its impact and promote healthy aging. And once again, healthy lifestyle comes first. This includes a balanced diet, which I will be talking about, getting regular exercise, getting enough sleep, maintaining stress, emotional resilience, flexibility in consciousness, maintaining biological rhythms, making love the most important experience in life. All this helps. Of course, on a more obvious level, limiting exposure to toxins includes not smoking, excessive alcohol consumption, environmental toxins. But the exciting part right now is that a lot of researchers are actively exploring strategies to address stem cell exhaustion. On the completely reductionist side, even stem cell exhaustion can be addressed through even stem cell transplants, which will happen in the near future. But also, there are now various phytochemicals, adaptogens, signal molecules that are being looked at, and I'll be talking a lot about these, that actually prevents, not only prevents stem cell exhaustion, but actually potentiate the differentiation of stem cells and also potentiate their liveliness or their freshness. Stem cells originally were found only in the bone marrow. And lots of, you can get lots of stem cells, fresh stem cells from the discarded of miscarriages, for example, so they can be harvested. But stem cell transplant and gene editing, these therapies are now soon going to be available and will be actually a complement to everything else that I'm saying. But let's go back to fundamentals. What is it that organize itself into the activity of stem cells, their ability to differentiate, their ability to replicate. What is behind all this? Okay. How do we even know that this is happening? Because I've always maintained that everything I'm saying with words is actually a symbolic representation of the inconceivable, incomprehensible awareness or consciousness that is behind the scenes organizing this infinite organizing power. So you can see that these potential therapies, including harvesting of stem cells, which is already being done, by the way, in the United States, in many places, the harvesting of stem cells from placenta without hurting anybody, okay, without any moral consequences. I'm talking about placenta that is there in spontaneous miscarriages. And then, of course, the future of gene editing. But I think most of that will become irrelevant if we understand the organizing part of consciousness behind this and have access to it. And of course, we have access to it through transcendence. When we transcend, we escape the whole theater of space, time, and causality. Okay, sorry to riff on this. I was only planning to share with you the meaning of stem cell exhaustion and how to prevent it through lifestyle, but then all these other things came to mind as I was speaking. I will continue with this series on health span and what we can do to minimize the discomfort that comes from aging. Ultimately, we all have to die, but we might as well live in joy and creativity and connected to the source while we're at it, even though our lifetime, biological lifetime, which is the symbolic representation of the infinite Atman, even though if it's a flash of lightning in the sky, a little dewdrop. But why not upgrade the whole experience? Okay, today I rambled a little bit, so sorry about that. Thank you.